Welcome everyone to Half History Travel. I am your host, the Wilder Historian, and there is a question that I have gotten numerous times and heard discussed by history buffs my entire life. What if Jackson had been at Gettysburg? Or it might be phrased, what if Jackson survived? In this video, I try my best to answer that question with as much historical accuracy as a counterfactual question can be answered. One of the biggest reasons that people ask that question is that Jackson has taken on mythical status in the minds of Civil War aficionados. His Valley Campaign in 1862 is one of the most beautifully executed military campaigns in history. But he was human. We can't forget that. He made mistakes. He stood firm against Pope's Union Army at Second Manassas, but had his line broke at Fredericksburg. So just keep that in mind. He was one man and not a miracle worker. At Chancellorsville, he was mistakenly shot by his own men, lost an arm due to it, and then died of pneumonia a few days later. What if he did not succumb to the pneumonia and continued with Lee and the Army of Northern Virginia? The victory at Chancellorsville only gave confidence to Lee that another invasion of the North was in order, plus an invasion of the North would draw the Union Army out of Virginia and relieve the devastated areas in the Virginia countryside that the two armies had destroyed. This is where it gets tricky, because now we have to assume a lot. After Jackson's death, Lee split his corps into two, making a three-corps army out of the Army of Northern Virginia, giving one corps to A.P. Hill and the other to Richard Ewell. If we are going to ask the question, what if Jackson was at Gettysburg, we have to assume that Jackson would have moved his troops along the same paths that Hill and Ewell moved theirs and happened to meet at Gettysburg, like what actually happened. So, let's assume that he would have. And Gettysburg opens up the same exact way, with Confederate forces pushing back the Federals to Cemetery Ridge and Culp's Hill. Would Jackson's being there changed anything? Yes, I can safely say from Jackson's tactical history that he would not have stopped at dark, just like he did at Chancellorsville. He would have pushed on, maybe even more so because of the great victory won at Chancellorsville using that tactic. However, that means that the entire layout of the battlefield would have changed. I would not hazard to guess what General Meade would have done with the Army of the Potomac had the Confederates succeeded in capturing all of the vital high ground. The Battle of Gettysburg could have just ended there, and another major battle of the war would have happened at another place in Pennsylvania, possibly Harrisburg or another major city. Yes, Jackson would have altered the Battle of Gettysburg, but in what significant way, no one can be sure. Here's what many antiquarians hypothesize. If Lee would have destroyed the Army of the Potomac in Pennsylvania, he would have marched on Washington, D.C. and captured it, and with Jackson, he could have done it. I just can't see where that would be anywhere in likelihood of possibility. For one, the Army of Northern Virginia could not have destroyed the Army of the Potomac in any significant way to keep it from being a threat. Civil War generals believed they could, but ultimately, a battle of annihilation where an entire army is wiped off the map was not possible. Not one of the major armies, at least. If you don't believe me, look at the battles of Franklin and Nashville. The Army of Tennessee was essentially destroyed, but it still reformed, and Johnston would use it in the Carolinas until he surrendered it in late April 1865. Even the Confederate army that surrendered at Vicksburg didn't just go away. Thousands upon thousands of men simply rejoined the Confederate ranks. Why would the Army of the Potomac be any different? But let's assume, and that's a big assumption, that the Army of the Potomac is gone, no more, no longer a threat. Lee marches on Washington. The capital was heavily fortified. Lee would have lost countless amounts of men attempting to take it. Lincoln would not have been captured. He most likely would have gotten out of the city some way, especially since he could have went by water out of the capital and there is no significant Confederate Navy to stop him. Plus, Lincoln would not have given up. He had an incredible amount of determination. But again, there are a lot of assumptions to even bring the President of the United States to that position in the first place. Too many assumptions to think of as a possibility. Now, let's try this avenue. Jackson survives, Lee invades, but has to leave the North and return to Virginia. Let us assume that everything works out the same. Vicksburg falls on July 4th, Chattanooga was captured by Grant, and he takes command of all Union forces, placing his headquarters with the Army of the Potomac. Does Jackson alter Grant's victories and allow the Confederacy to win? The short answer, no. Even if Jackson had pulled off a major tactical victory against Grant, Grant was a bulldog on the battlefield. He never let defeat slow him down. He kept plugging away. Furthermore, it wouldn't have mattered had the Confederacy possessed the greatest tactician of all time. By 1864, the Union had cut off so much supplies from getting to Lee and his army that it was simply a matter of time before the Confederacy lost. Now, I'm not saying that it is a foregone conclusion that the Confederacy was going to lose, but if it was going to win, it would have done so within the first year, maybe year and a half of the war, before the Union made significant inroads into the Western theater. Those are my thoughts. Do you agree with me? Let me know what you think, and let's keep the discussion going in the comments. Ultimately, I don't think Jackson would have had a significant impact on the outcome of the war by the time of his death. The pieces were already in place for a Union victory by the summer of 1863. Thank you all so much for watching. Have a great day, and I'll see you next time.
Historian, historian, where do you roam? Historian, historian, far, far from home. Have history, will travel, reads the card of a man. A professor with knowledge in the heartland. To educate the world is his mission. A professor of fortune is a man called historian. Historian.